Greetings, everybody, and welcome back to what I hope is going to be the finale of Shovel Knight Plague of Shadows. I didn't notice it until now, but it seems that once the Enchantress's Tower opens up, the world map theme becomes really ominous. At any rate, let's get to it. And I'd like to try out a couple of different bomb combinations that people suggested to me. I've really had a hell of a time adapting to the playstyle of Plague Knight throughout this whole series. I got so used to Shovel Knight, and just haven't been able to fully recover from the habits I picked up during his campaign. What was it? The float casing, the sparkler powder, and the sentry fuse. A number of people had told me that this combination was apparently really good. I guess because the electrical powder with the homing case just constantly damages enemies until it dissipates. So, I don't know, I'll give that a shot. See what's down here. Oh. Wonderful. Alright. Trying to tell if there's anything over on that wall I might be able to destroy, but... Oh, see, and this is going to be the worst. Those two cipher coins, three I see now floating there, are exactly the same color as this background. Oh, God. Ah! I forgot I didn't have the float burst equipped. Apparently I still had the spin burst equipped from a previous recording. I'm gonna go back to this for now. I know a lot of people have been yelling at me for overusing the float burst. Frankly, I understand, but it's either get yelled at for using the float burst or get yelled at for missing cipher coins. There's no winning. Actually, I don't know why I bothered picking up that money, because at this point... interesting. Okay, well, I'll continue trying this combination out a little bit and see how it serves. I've probably already missed the cipher coin. Or a secret area. Ah, but I love that you can do this much more easily as Plague Knight than Shovel Knight. Actually... you know what? I think this is a really good combination for this area! Alright, I'm convinced. Thank you to everybody who suggested that! This, on the other hand, I think, is going to be a little more complicated. Right here. Yay! I see it, guys, I see it, I know. This one, and this one. God, I really hate that those coins are the exact same color as the background. And what's this? A rogue plague minion? Come on! Really, dude? As if I don't have enough problems on my hands as it is. Waiting for him to just blow up the floor underneath him. Doesn't look like he's going to. Alright then, I will help you. Where are my fish bombs? There we go. Well, I probably... I guess it worked out. I was gonna say I should have done that first, but actually, I think this was the correct order. Oh, this is gonna suck. Actually, not as bad as I was expecting. These blasted fish. There. Ah, crap! I forgot about that. Well, all things considered, I suppose I can't complain too much. I do actually really like this combination, these bombs. Oh, that's right, that doesn't kill you, I forgot. Oh, but apparently that does. Jeez. Way to throw somebody's expectations off. Well, that wasn't quite the way I was hoping that would play out, but I guess I can't complain. Gonna wait for my magic to recharge here. I definitely want my contingency. There we are. I just hope I didn't miss any cipher coins. Ah! Damn it, I realized it a second too late. Well, I'll know for next time, I guess. Ahead of myself again. Wow, this... I'm not really rightly sure what to say at this point. This is entirely my own error here, but... it's embarrassing nonetheless. Come on. Ugh. I should have just waited. There we go. Jeez. All right. Oh, yes. I definitely see the value of these bombs against this enemy type. Wow. Alright, thank goodness. Now that's done with. Let's see if I can collect these cipher coins. Or that one. It doesn't look like there are any more here. Alright. That never gets old. I'm fairly sure there was a secret area over here. Yes. He couldn't decide whether he wanted to run forward and YOLO it or stay back where it was safe. For goodness sake, I thought that would do enough damage to kill him. Oh well. Okay, interesting. What am I missing here? I know I'm missing something. I know, guys, apart from that obvious cipher coin that's right in front of my face, come on. These bombs are really handy. There it only took one hit. Or maybe that was just an illusion and it was actually two really quick consecutive hits. Hard to say. It seems kind of silly to me that they put gems around this area to bait you when, presumably anyway, by this point in the game, you have no need whatsoever for those gems. Anything up here? Nope, just another bomb. Alright. Wait a minute, no. With my luck... Really? Oh god, how many cipher coins have they hidden in this area? I almost don't want to know. Well, actually, I see now that the cipher coins in this area are shadowed as well, so they actually should be a little bit easier to see. Thank goodness. Come on! Ah, he's too smart for that. He knows. Okay, maybe he doesn't. Those stupid dragons. see, what's down here? Music! Excellent. Long will be very pleased. Oh, okay, so that one right in front of me is solid. Anything over there. Got that. That looks to be the last one here. Thank goodness. Okay. Oh, all right. I'll take it. Okay, I stand corrected. It was not the last cipher coin here. Oh, geez, not by a long shot. And somebody had pointed out to me when I came through here as Shovel Knight that it is actually possible to tell which platforms you can stand on based on where the rain is falling. Thank you for pointing that out, I appreciate it. I mean, better late than never, right? Aw, not one of you punks again. I swear to God, the Hover Meanie is the most asshole enemy in this entire game. That down there is a very clear troll, as is that other one. I won't be fooled that easily. Alright, I think that's everything. I don't see any more anyway. Alright, we get to fight Black Knight now. Unless it turns out it's actually Shovel Knight. What do I want for this fight? Probably the vampire juice, I guess. And it seems here that Black Knight is already possessed by the Enchantress. Actually, it occurs to me. Oh, really? Those don't track him when he's, teleporting? Okay, well, what should I use? This is tough. Yeah, I guess I'll just go with the bounce casing. Maybe the cluster powder. And the impact fuse. So, as far as I can tell, the, yes, if I can corner trap him. The spin burst doesn't quite grant invincibility frames, but... it does seem to protect you from contact damage. This is bad. Oh, he was deflecting the bombs I was throwing at him. Great. Maybe the lob casing will work a little bit better. Actually, I wonder if the lob casing and the sentry fuse, since he likes to spend lots of time in the air. Yeah, that seems to be working quite a bit better. At least when he's in the air. Ah. There we go. Oh, I don't get an essence from him, I guess. You know, Black Knight is right. Wow. Plague Knight definitely seems to have a very singular obsession with getting his hands on this potion. Too bad he didn't listen to Black Knight. Right, let me go back to town and turn in some musics. And I see that from my cipher coin count, it looks like I missed 3. At this point, honestly, I don't really care. I'm just gonna go back and get them off camera. Thanks, Baz. You're the best. Oh, right. God, I have to give them to Percy. Alright. I guess I'll go back to that other combination for now. That seemed to be working out fairly well. Alright, we're a few minutes early, but I don't think there's going to be quite enough content to round out another half-hour episode in addition to this. So I'm going to wrap it up here, and I guess the next episode will be the finale. Thank you all for joining me, and I look forward to seeing everybody then. Take care.